and there's no noise complaints. Plus, a signed affidavit from Will's babysitter confessing that he bribed her.
Great.
Let's win this.
Actually, guys, I'm going to have to meet you at the commission. I've got a business meeting to go to.
What? This is a business meeting.
I'll meet you at the hearing. It's not going to take long.
You're the licensee.
Yeah, I am also the managing director of a company, and I need to kick a major goal today so that Abby doesn't have to keep working her bottom off.
Dear Mrs. Crabb, by the time you read this, we'll be a long way away. Why have we eloped? We've decided on a modest service at a registry office. Please don't be cross. It's just that we're very excited and passionate young people who act without thinking and live for the moment, except for taking the time to write this note. Thank you for reading. Warm regards, Phoebe and Ryan. P.S. Hope you don't mind, we borrowed your car.
It'll do. Come on, baby. We're going on an adventure.
Well, we can't go in without him. He's the bloody licensee.
He said he was coming.
I am very interested in the position, and I'm quite flattered. I have to go now.
You said that two drinks ago.
It was five drinks ago, actually. That is the best whiskey I think I've ever tasted.
There's plenty more where that came from.
Afternoon,
excuse
gentlemen.
Me, you can't come in here.
Do I know you?
This is just...
Sorry, no time for introductions.
What are you doing? Oh, boys!
It's very nice to meet you. Stay in touch. At least they're just mates. You're going to be right to read your own statement?
Yeah, I'm fine, I'm fine.
Just let us do the talking, OK?
Oh, you reek of booze.
They love my idea.
They've already called you.
Mr. Mark Oliver, room 5. Mr. Mark
That's
Oliver.
That's us. You guys ready?
I've got to go to the toilet.
You can't.
No, I'll be just too... Just...
You take this. I'll get it.
This is the final call for Mr. Mark Oliver. Room 5. Mr. Mark Oliver.
And having said that, Your Honour, we are mindful of the need to coexist with our neighbours. And as you can see from our documentation, we have an enormous amount of community support.
Well, you lost all your points in a very short space of time.
Well, the licensee's statement will make it clear that we weren't actually responsible for that.
So which one of you is the licensee?
He's just freshening up.
Sir.
This hearing has been convened specifically to deal with the licensee.
Oh, he's coming. Yeah, I'll just go get him.
How is he?
Mark, you okay?
Look, just stall him. I'll have him out in a minute, okay?
Maybe a minute and a half. Go.
Mark! No, he's coming, Your Honour. He's just got a bit of a stomach bug.
All right, that's it. No more, all right? This is absurd. Now, under the terms of this hearing, failure to appear means I have no choice but to...
Sorry, I'm late, sir. Thank you very much for your patience. I'm the licensee, Mark Oliver.
Good. All right, take your place behind the table. Thank you, Mr. Oliver.
Yeah, no worries. And please, call me Mark.
So, as licensee of the Mill Hotel, you have made an application to have your license revocation overturned.
Yeah, exactly.
So can you outline your grounds for the application, please?
He's not very comfortable talking in public, Your Honour.
I need to hear from the licensee.
We're just a bunch of blokes running a local pub where everyone's welcome for a pint and a chat. No pokies, no overpriced wine lists, no fancy fit-outs. Just a daggy carpet and a nod to the 70s. The community love us because we love them. We run raffles for the local footy teams, ballet drinks for the mums, and there's a veal palmy and a beer with your name on it, Commissioner. But not on the house, of course, because that would be corruption. We've learnt from our mistakes. The noise is under control, and I'll be asking for your ID when you come in. But if you shut us down, then you'll be shutting down a way of life, a community spirit that you and I both know is already dying everywhere.
Sorry, who are you?
That's Ned.
His son.
I had him young.
Sorry for the interruption, sir. Ned's a casual at the pub.
Ned, this is a tribunal. No. You can't just wander in here.
Hey, Ned, just a word outside, thank you. Let's get outside. Sorry for the interruption, sir. Employees, no respect. Where were we?
He can't be me.
Why not?
That's identity theft.
He's sober and he's here on time. He's like the new and improved version of you.
I'm sorry I'm late, okay, but I just got a job offer.
Oh, great. Congratulations.
I'm not going to take it. I'm committed to the pub.
Oh, yeah, and we're really feeling that commitment, Mark.
I said I was sorry.
You missed the hearing.
They made me drink whiskey.
They made you.
How about this guy?
Yeah.
The commissioner's going to let us know tomorrow.
But he loved him.
Commended him on his community spirit.
You were awesome in there, mate.
Hey, listen, mate, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to steal any of your thunder. I was just trying to help.
All good. Thank you.
Yeah, well, don't thank me till tomorrow. Wait, see if you guys can hold on to your license.
Gemma!
Why haven't you been answering your phone?
Oh, I was in there.
Phoebe has eloped. They didn't want to get married around people who were fighting.
Well, who's fighting?
I'm not fighting.
Oh, you're fighting now.
This is ridiculous. She's 19 years old.
They're in love.
We're going after them to stop them, right?
Wrong.
What?
Well, if two people want to get married, they should.
But...
You know what? Ryan is the most beautiful boy in the world and he adores her and she adores him. Even if she doesn't admit it, I just feel terrible that we're ruining it for them. It's the most important day of their lives. They should be surrounded by family and friends. We're going to go after them, all right, but we're going to convince them to have it at home.
So you're all for this?
Of course.
Isn't that a bit weird, given what's going on between us?
I'm not anti-marriage, Lewis. I'm just anti-marriage to you.
School pickup only takes a minute, then I'll drop you at the pub.
Yeah, no worries. Nice school.
Right, well, I'll just wait here. Oh, Poppy comes down from her school and meets me.
Well, she doesn't go here.
Nah, she goes to a private school.
Oh.
A reminder, photo day this week. I need all children in full school uniform. Thank
Ew,
you.
Awesome. Show us.
Alex.
Hey.
Hi. You probably just saw that. Mm. He's a friend. He doesn't really know kids that well.
Yeah, we'll get it back.
The wombat.
Swapped it for the sunnies. Designer.
Plastic.
Plastic sunglasses for a second-hand wombat. Seems like a fair trade, eh?
This is it?
Yep. Welcome to Sunrise Waters.
This is where we're taking our wedding vows.
Yeah.
Where's the water?
What?
It's called Sunrise Waters. Where's the water?
Well, maybe there was water once, but it dried up. It was the cheapest registry.
When you said Sunrise Waters, I was picturing us on a romantic beach. Long stretches of white sand, us looking amazing, me anyway.
You do look amazing. It was really expensive to get the registry celebrant to leave the building. But we've got free biscuits and cordial, plus I've packed us a ham sandwich to keep our energy up. I thought you didn't want a fuss. What are you doing?
I've got cold feet.
What?
We're nearly there. It's just around the corner.
Baby! Come back! I love you! Ryan!
Hey, Ryan!
Don't... Can I offer you a ham sandwich, Mr. and Mrs. Crabb?
No thanks, Ryan.
So I guess it didn't turn out.
Sunrise Waters is a hole.
It wasn't that bad.
It was windy and it was cold. There was no water.
Might have been warm inside the registry, but you refused to stay.
It's because it smelt like old people.
Oh, well, maybe it's a good thing. I shouldn't need to tell you guys. Once you're married, there's bigger bumps in the road than a cold day in a registry that smells of old people. It's better to know now.
Hang on, just because I hate Sunrise Waters doesn't mean I hate Ryan. He's Ryan. I love his guts. That's not going to change no matter where we are.
But you had cold feet.
About eloping, not about marrying you. Look, I know I said I didn't want to make a fuss, but I changed my mind. I was just trying to be sensitive to you and Dad splitting up and everything. I spent $75 on this dress. I want to show it off. Now.
Now.
How quickly can you organize a real wedding?
Wedding in 24 hours.
Yep.
Of course I'm cooking.
They'll need wine, glasses, chairs. I'll take the first batch over this arbor.
So, how are things going with Lucy?
Yeah, great. You know, decided to be friends.
Oh.
What are you guys doing?
What's it look like?
Mate, they suspended your license.
What did you forget about that bit.
Yeah, they'll make a decision in 24 hours, then we'll need beer.
Yeah, if they don't shut you down.
They won't shut us down.
Well, always good to be confident.
You stole a wombat.
Mate, I didn't steal a wombat. I negotiated for the wombat. My son's birthday.
You've got a kid?
Yeah, he turns four today. Turns five today. Five, four, one of those.
Hey. Working hard?
Yeah.
Look, I was thinking, if everything works out and we get our license back, I might keep myself at arm's length as far as the pub goes, you know what I mean?
No, I wouldn't take a wage. Maybe Ned could have a few more hours.
Oh, jeez, mate.
Why's that?
Well, as you know, I got an offer.
A job offer?
Hmm.
The one you weren't meant to take?
Yeah. Funny how life evolves.
See, the problem is, you know, being licensee, you really need to be around.
Oh, no, I'd still keep my hand in.
You need to give a toss.
I do.
Yeah, I'm not really seeing that, Mark.
Trust him.
And since Ned did a better job of being you, maybe we need to make that permanent. He can be licensee.
Well, hang on, I don't want to step on anyone's toes.
Well, we don't need to make any decisions just yet.
No, it's good that we sorted out. I'll see you later.
I love you!
Gentlemen, you ready for school photo day? Shoes polished?
Oh, they will be.
I think I'll wear green.
Oh, lovely.
That's my favourite colour.
Really? Alex loves green.
OK, I don't want to be rude, Miss Levy, but just because Alex is a...
homosexual.
Exactly.
And you are too.
It doesn't mean we're going to hit it off. Lots of people make this mistake. Just like any couple, that there needs to be a connection.
Well, of course there does. You two are perfect for each other. You're just too stupid to realise it.
Before you say anything, just hear me out. Poppy has been the saddest she has ever been in her entire life.
Okay, I'm sensing some emotional blackmail here.
Can you just go on one more date with Miss Ruby's nephew, please?
You have got to be kidding me. Cashew?
Yeah. Is this a date?
Oh, yeah?
Interesting venue.
I'm sorry it's so close to the school. I'm in a bit of a hurry.
To get over Will. You guys split up, right? On chemistry?
Well, there was chemistry. He was using me to buy the pub.
That doesn't seem like chemistry.
But actually, it was. I liked him a lot.
Seems like you were trying to invent the chemistry to convince yourself you liked him. Because he fits the mold.
What mold?
Good job, wears a suit, got a kid, doesn't eat goat.
I didn't mind the goat.
You hated the goat.
Okay, nose-to-tail dining isn't my thing.
No, you take your dates to park benches.
Look, I asked you here quickly for a favour. My niece, Poppy, she wants to return and appear in South, and Given your connection with Miss Luby, I thought maybe you could...
Use me the same way that Will used you.
No. No, no, I...
That guilt was wasted on you.
Kane, how'd it go?
I can't help you. You dumped me.
Thank you so much for seeing me.
You got 5 minutes.
When you suspended Poppy, I may have overreacted.
You usually do.
I regret taking her out of the school.
It's good to admit our mistakes. I'm always telling the children to do that.
We'd like her back in.
Absolutely. As I said, next year.
Poppy so wants to be in the photo tomorrow.
What a shame.
I didn't know you were Justice of the Peace.
I have many civic duties. I'm also a registered celebrant.
Really?
Unfortunately, there's a bit of a glut. A lot of new age types getting into it. I don't get many opportunities.
I didn't mean to use you. I'm not the using type. It was actually for my sister. So, not really my use, if that makes sense. I don't want you to take this the wrong way, but when we first met, I thought you were a little odd. But now that I've gotten to know you, I think that I might be the odd one. Or maybe both of us are. It doesn't matter. The point is that I want to make it up to you. Everything. Me using you, dumping you, taking you to the park for a date, my skepticism regarding the goat. There's a wedding on the Savo, and I want you to come. No hidden agenda, just good food, good times.
Not supposed to talk in the library. This is just a little something for Phoebe and Ryan.
Ah.
Oh. You know, just wish them all the best.
That's lovely.
Hi, Mrs. Crabb.
Ryan, is everything all right?
Can we talk?
Yeah.
Happy wedding day, mate.
Okay, I'm calling a group meeting.
What now?
I've got an announcement to make. I've quit my job.
You're kidding.
On the first day?
They're not my people. You're my people. I know sometimes I need to be reminded of that, but well, if you have me back. Oh, sorry. It's them. It's the commission.
Well, answer it.
I'm not Mark Oliver. Here, you have to do it, mate.
They can't see you.
Hello?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. The mill is back in business.
Oh, look,
only thing is, I don't want to do the licensee thing. I am over it. And as you're the only one without a criminal record, Ned, it's up to you.
Well, I wasn't serious about that. I mean, the only reason I said yes is because I thought you guys were rooted.
What are you going to do now?
You got a family to support.
I got a place right near the pub. A few spare bedrooms. If you're interested.
Fellas, we got a bit of a runaway groom situation.
I can't go through with this. Face it, Mr. Crabb, if you can't pull off a marriage, what chance do I have?
Ryan, look, I'm probably not the right person for you to compare yourself with.
You're the closest thing I've ever had to a dad.
Yeah, but I got a lot more flaws than you have, mate.
He does.
Shut up, Kane. Gemma backs you.
What?
When I heard you guys were getting married, I wasn't sure. Actually, I thought it was a dumb idea. But Gemma, well, she thinks you're perfect for each other.
She said that.
That's enough for me. And Phoebe's my daughter, so that should be enough for you.
She's too good for me, okay? She's Phoebe. She's gorgeous. She's funny. She's smart.
She's a woman.
Yeah, they package them better.
They look better.
They smell better.
They're insane.
Mm.
Yeah, but in a good way.
we're not worthy.
You just gotta hope you get to spend the rest of your life with the woman you love before she figures it out.
Well, I don't have a ring.
I've got one.
What? You just walk around carrying wedding rings in your pocket?
Yeah, I like to come prepared. Right. Should we do this thing?
I'm glad you made it.
Hey, this is nice.
When does Poppy go to school?
Tomorrow, back in Miss Levy's class.
You are very good.
I know.
All right.
Oh, oh, look.
Marriage is a spiritual union. It's also a physical union, which is nearly more important.
Did she just say more important?
Yeah.
I now pronounce you man and wife. You may now kiss the bride. Come on. You can do better than that. And